आई एम डॉक्टर डब्ल्यू बी गुनोले फ्रॉम कमला नेहरू महाविद्यालय नागपुर. टुडे वी आर डिस्कसिंग द इम्पॉर्टेंट मेटल नाइट्रोसिन एंड इन दिस नाइट्रोसो फेरस सल्फेट इज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट मेटल नाइट्रोसिन एंड इन टुडेज पार्ट वी आर डिस्कसिंग द प्रिपरेशन ऑफ नाइट्रोसो फेरस सल्फेट एंड स्ट्रक्चर एंड बॉन्डिंग ऑफ नाइट्रोसो फेरस सल्फेट मेटल नाइट्रोसिन कॉम्प्लेक्स. सो इन दिस कॉम्प्लेक्स Fe दैट इज आयरन इज इन अ प्लस वन ऑक्सीडेशन स्टेट. This indicate that there are number of unpaired electrons. So, therefore, this metal complex is a paramagnetic in nature, and we are discussing the structure. So, that structure shows the paramagnetic nature because of the presence of one or more unpaired electrons. So, this is an important compound, and preparation and properties of the nitroso ferrous sulfate metal nitrosyl we are discussing in today's part. So today's topic is metal nitrosyl, and this is the part number 3. And in this part today we are discussing the important metal nitrosyl, that is nitroso ferrous sulfate. And here, so what is the preparation of metal carbonyl, properties of metal carbonyl, and structural bonding of the important metal nitrosyl, nitroso ferrous sulfate. So here, first of all, we will discuss the preparation, that is of the metal carbonyl, and compound is a nitroso ferrous sulfate, and all other name is nitronium penta echo iron sulfate complex, and the formula is FeNO plus H2O5SO4. So this is known as nitroso ferrous sulfate or nitronium penta echo iron sulfate. So this metal nitrosyl, in this case the of metal complex, nitrosyl complex, the oxidation state of Fe metal is a plus 1, therefore it has odd number of electrons, and therefore it is expected that this metal carbonyl is a paramagnetic in nature. So this is shown here, preparation of this nitroso ferrous sulfate. And in this case of nitroso ferrous sulfate, method is when freshly prepared ferrous sulfate solution and few drops of concentrated nitric acid is added to the aqueous solution of NaNO3 along the side of the test tube, then browning of the nitroso ferrous sulfate is formed at the junction of the two liquid. Therefore the formation of nitroso ferrous sulfate complex take place, and it involve the formation of this complex consists of three steps. The formation of nitroso ferrous sulfate complex consists of three steps. So this is an important preparation, and at the last we get brown colored ring and at the junction of the two solution. And the first step is now sodium nitrate. Here what is the first step? Sodium nitrate react with the concentrated H2SO4 and form HNO3. So in the first step, nitric acid HNO3 is formed. How it is formed is shown the reaction. Sodium nitrate NaNO3 plus H2SO4, they react and forming NaHSO4, NaHSO4, and H and NO3, HNO3 is formed. And HNO3 have two ions, H plus and NO3 minus. NO3 minus is a nitrate ion. So this is the step one. In this step, sodium nitrate react with the concentrated sulfuric acid and form HNO3. So in this case, sodium nitrate react with the sulfuric acid forming NaH sodium bisulfate and HNO3 nitric acid. So in the step 1, nitric acid is formed. And second step, in this second step, nitric acid formed in the first step oxidize ferrous sulfate to ferric sulfate. Now see here, this is the ferrous sulfate Fe2+, ferric Fe3+. Fe2+ is a ferrous, Fe3+ is a ferric. So in the second step, nitric acid formed in the step 2 oxidized ferrous sulfate to ferric sulfate in the presence of sulfuric acid. In this process, nitric acid reduces itself to NO, and in this step, nitric acid itself reduces to the NO, that is nitric oxide. And in this step, desired species is the NO, nitric oxide. So main product in this step is a nitric oxide, that is NO. See the reaction of ferrous sulfate six molecule, three molecule of sulfuric acid, and two molecule of HNO3. So this is the freshly prepared ferrous sulfate. React with sulfuric acid and in presence of nitric acid. What did we get here? Three molecules of Fe2SO4 thrice. So here Fe2, 3 plus, so it is ferric sulfate, and 4 molecules of water and 2 molecules of NO. So this is the main product, nitric oxide, in the second step. So here in the step step 2, the desired species is the nitric oxide NO, and the reaction is shown. So in this way, in this, nitric acid oxidized ferrous sulfate to ferric sulfate, and HNO3 is reduces to NO. So in this way, the second step is there in the preparation of nitrous of ferrous sulfate. Now third step, NO, that is nitric oxide, obtained in the step 2 is absorbed by aqueous solution of ferrous sulfate and forming brown black ring. And formula of this brown black ring, FeNOH2O5SO4, which is known as nitrous of ferrous sulfate, is formed, and the reaction is shown here. And this brown black ring is due to the Fe plus NO bonding is there, and charge transfer band occurring in this visible region. So here NO to Fe, so here from NO donate electron to Fe and forming charge transfer band occurring in the visible region of this spectrum. So this is the step 3, and the reaction is shown in the step 3, how it is there. And in the step 3, this is the nitric oxide obtained in the second step, FeSO4, 5 molecules of water. So in this case, we get the complex FeNOH2O5SO4. This is the black brown. So see now here, Fe and SO4 is here, NO is here, and 5 molecules of water here. So addition compound, brown black ring is obtained in this case. So this is the nitrous of ferrous sulfate, and in this, there is a formation of bond. What is the bond? Charge transfer band is there. NO plus donate electron to the Fe plus and forming the coordinate bond. So in this way, formation of this bond, the color of the complex is a brown black colored ring is obtained, and therefore it is very important test, or it is important reaction for to test the qualitative inorganic radical, that is nitrate or nitrite ion. As we have seen, what is the Browning test? So this is the Browning test. So preparation of nitrous of ferrous sulfate consists of 3 steps. In the first step, important product is HNO3. In the second step, nitric oxide is the important desired species. And in the third, we get the brown black ring in which there is a NOFE bond is present, coordinate bond is present. And therefore, the color of this complex is brown black color. And so important compound, this is the metal nitrosyl. And this metal nitrosyl is prepared, and it consists of this step, first, second and third. So this is a simple, and this is the brown black ring obtained at the junction of the two solution during the test in the last. So the brown black color ring is obtained is due to the donation of electron from NO to Fe, which is also known as charge transfer band occurring in the visible region, and therefore they show color. Now important properties of this metal nitrosyl, as we have seen, nitrosinium penta aqua iron sulfate is a brown in color, and the formation of this complex is very useful in the identification of nitrate test for nitrate ion and nitrite ion, NO3 minus, NO2 minus, in the qualitative inorganic analysis. The test for these ions in inorganic qualitative analysis of acidic radical is shown also as a brown ring test in inorganic quantitative analysis. The test is known as a brown ring test, and all the reactions shown here of the nitrous of penta aqua iron sulfate occur during this brown ring test. Whenever we perform the brown ring test in the identification of nitrate ion or nitrite ion, these three reactions are taking place, and therefore we at the last we obtain a brown color ring of the complex. So that brown ring is nothing but the formation of nitrous of ferrous sulfate complex. So here this is an important metal nitrosyl. And now structural bonding of this important metal nitrosyl, nitrosonium penta iron complex. So according to the valence bond theory, formation of iron can be explained as shown here. See the as we know in this metal complex, Fe is the metal and atom number Fe is 26. So electronic configuration is in the ground state argon 3d6 4s2. So Fe in the ground state have configuration argon 3d6 4s2 is the valence shell. Now in the metal carbonyl nitrosulfuric sulfate, in this case Fe have plus 1 charge. So plus 1 means there is a loss of 1 electron. So there is a loss of electron from 4s. So 1 electron is lost, and now we have this configuration as it is. Here is a 1 electron, because 1 electron is lost. There is a loss because plus 1. So this is the configuration of Fe, and this is the configuration of Fe1, Fe plus 1. Plus 1 means 1 electron, this electron is lost. So here 4s have only 1 electron. Now Fe plus, after rearrangement, that is in the excited state, we can say that this electron is shifted here. So see here, this is electron shifted, it becomes now paired, and 3 electrons are as it is. So 1s, 3p and 2d orbital undergo hybridization forming sp3d2 hybrid orbital. So what is here? 1s, 3p and 2d orbital undergoes hybridization and forming 6 sp3d2 hybrid orbital of equivalent energy. And after this, now 6 ligands are there, 5 water and 1 NO plus. The 6 ligands donate electron pair to the vacant sp3d2 hybrid orbital. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So these 6 ligands donate electron pair, and the configuration of the this is the formation of complex FeNOH2O5 sulfate. Sulfate is in a counter line. So here I think this is the configuration. So in this case, 3D, this configuration as it is. So vacant orbital accept the electron from the 6 ligand forming coordinate bond. In this way, here this 6 orbital have electron pair and forming the coordinate bond 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And therefore the hybridization is here sp3d2. 6 hybrid orbital are there in a metal and accept electron from the 6 ligand, 5 water and 1 NO plus. In this way, the formation can be explained on the basis of this, and because of the hybridization is sp3d2, we can say that the complex is a octahedral in shape. And again now see here, in this complex formation, 1, 2, 3 are the unpaired electron in the complex. Therefore, this complex have unpaired electron, 3 unpaired electron, therefore it is paramagnetic in nature. And in the next slide, it is shown structure of this complex nitrosonium penta ico iron. So see here, Fe plus 1, it is in a center, this is center metal ion, Fe plus, and 1 NO is there, and 5 H2O, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So see, 6 are there, and therefore the shape, and this is sulfate, and therefore the structure of this is an octahedral structure, or this complex have nitrosonium penta ico iron have octahedral structure. So because sp3d2 is the hybridization, and d2 is a d orbital is a outer, therefore outer orbital complex, outer orbital octahedral complex. So this is an important structure of the nitrosulfuric sulfate, or also known as nitrosonium penta ico iron. So preparation and properties and structure and bonding of this important metal nitrosyl we have seen in this part. And as you know, due to the presence of 3 unpaired electron, the complex is a paramagnetic in nature, and experimentally it is also confirmed the magnetic moment correspond to the 3 unpaired electron, and therefore magnetic moment value mu is equal to 3.9 bm. Bm is Bohr magneton. So due to the presence of 3 unpaired electron, the complex is paramagnetic in nature, and presence of 3 unpaired electron is also experimentally confirmed, and the magnetic moment corresponds to the 3 unpaired electron, and the magnetic moment value is mu is equal to 3.9 bm, Bohr magneton. And similarly, the crystal field theory also shows 3 unpaired electron in this complex. As complex is high spin, so configuration as the three unpaired electrons are there, and therefore the complex is high spin. Therefore the configuration is T2G5EG2. Octahedral, na? In case of octahedral, in CFT diagram, T2G have low energy, EG have high energy. So because of the high spin, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 electrons are going, and then 2 are paired. So 3 unpaired electrons are there. So this crystal field theory also suggests the high, because of the high spin, the CFT configuration is T2G5EG2. T2G have 5 electrons, EG have 2 electrons. EG have 2 electrons is 2 unpaired, and T2G have 3, so 2 orbitals are paired and 1 is having single electron. So 3 unpaired electrons are there. So CFT also confirms the presence of 3 unpaired electrons. Experimentally also shows 3 unpaired electrons, therefore this complex is paramagnetic and high spin complexes. High spin and low spin complexes are there. Low spin have very low, less number of unpaired electrons. High spin have large number of unpaired electrons. So here 3 unpaired electrons are there, and magnetic moment value is also 3.9. So this is an important nitrosonium pentaquo iron or nitrosoferrous sulfate, as it is an important metal nitrosine. And in this case we have seen the preparation of important nitrosoferrous sulfate, and after that properties and structure and bonding of this important compound nitrosoferrous sulfate we have discussed. This is an important compound, and this nitrosoferrous sulfate is a complex and which is a brown in color, and sometimes it is also known as the Browning test, as we perform the inorganic qualitative analysis. So we perform Browning test for the nitrate ion, and same that Browning is obtained at the junction of the two solution, and it is nothing but the nitrosoferrous sulfate or nitronium pentaquo iron sulfate complex. So this is the important part of the metal nitrosine, and today we have seen the preparation properties and the structure and bonding of nitrosoferrous sulfate.